But I have a bra on right now, so my boobies probably look real big. Hello, my sewing friends. I am Cassidy. This is my YouTube channel. We're gonna do something different today. I am not churning out the type of tutorial content that I would like to be. So we're gonna do a sewing vlog. While there will be morsels and tidbits of tips and information and sewing wisdom, if you will, within the video, this is gonna be more of a vlog type format, not an instructional video. If you want instructional videos, I have plenty of those. And I will link my fashion and sewing playlist up in the corner. So if that sounds cool to you, stick around and let's get started. So I'm gonna start from the smallest things that I've made to the largest. Now I will not be trying on the things I'm about to show you, but they are two beautiful pairs of lace underwear. And this is a pattern from a Craftsy class. You can tell I made these a bit bigger than the other ones I'm gonna show you, but they had the lovely pico elastic along with the, so these are super cute, really flattering, and they do not take much fabric at all. And then I made this little green pair with the matching green pico elastic as well. So very happy with these. Another kind of undergarment-ish thing that I sewed is this one shoulder bikini top. Now, I'm not exactly going to count this as a win, but I do like the concept. I'll just throw it on real quick. So yeah, that's what it looks like on, but I have a bra on right now, so my boobies probably look real big, but I will be sewing this again. I'm just going to try a different fabric and try to get some dedicated insertable cups. So to be continued with this one. This was just the first try. All right, next are my tube tops. Now, wouldn't necessarily call these wins either because I find that this top binding right here is much too thin. I would like something thicker, but they do have built-in bras and, you know, it's a solid tube top. I did learn how to sew a tube top and learn what modifications I wanted to make. So I do like this white one quite a bit better than the Carol Baskin one. That's what we call my cheetah print fabric. So I've been sewing these. Next. Ooh, these are fun. These are two of my favorite shirts. So this is a very, very, very simple pattern. A very popular pattern as well on Etsy. And it's a little top that ties at the neck and ties at the back. It's self-lined, so there's no hems to sew or anything like that. And it's easy, but I've only made two and I am gonna make another one in red gingham. Another note, I was making matching masks to go with these tops since asked to match the shirt. And it would be so funny, like if I go to a restaurant or go out wherever, people would just look, like some people would just stare and not say anything. And other people would just be like, your mask and your shirt, they match, they're the same. How did you do that? And I'm like, Okay, so here are the two Astoria tops that I've sewed recently. I call this the $8 Macy's sale shirt because it looks like you bought it at Macy's for $8. I believe I got this fabric from the Trendy Outlet on Etsy. Honestly, not crazy about them, but it's not my favorite. It is a bit wide and does need to be a bit longer. And I also made the Astoria top out of this cotton Carol Baskin spandex. But those are the non-hoodie top. Hoodies and sweatshirts. I have four of them. So this is the first kind of attempt that I had at a hoodie. It's very plain and I just kind of folded under the seam here on the underarm, just stitch it with a straight stitch, left the hem undone, It's not the most flattering top I own. I have muscular arms. I'm not saying that they're big. I'm just saying that like where this hits me is not super flattering. You never want something to hit you at the widest part of whatever body part. So I like to throw this on over swimsuits. It's just super easy, casual, and it's made out of this lovely French terry that I'm obsessed with. So that was my first flirtation, shall we say, with French terry. And then it became a full on, we fell in love. French terry and I, it's a love story. I digress. So after I made that, I made dream suit number one. So this is the hoodie. And it has a pocket, unlike the hoodie for dream suit number two that does not have a pocket. So some different things I tried between the two of these. I used a twin needle on this and it looks a lot more professional, as to where with this one, I just kind of use a straight stitch. And yeah, but used the twin needle, was very careful to base the pocket in place. I tried to put a pocket on this one, but it didn't work out. It just looked really saggy and gross. And I was like, no, we're not doing this. So we have those two. And then the last one that I sewed is actually kind of in the fail category because the neckline is gaping. So we're gonna talk about this in the challenges I've faced part of this video. And I'm gonna show you how I'm gonna fix this. But just to show you what's going on here, love this sweater otherwise. The neckline gapes because I made the binding too long. So what I'm gonna do is cut the binding off and rebind the neckline. 9 times out of 10, when you're sewing, if you do make a mistake, unless you put a big old hole in the center front or get a stain on whatever you're working on, there are some problems that you cannot fix and you should just throw whatever you're working on away. But for the most part, I think that, at least for me, one of the funnest parts about sewing is encountering those challenges of like, oh man, like this is a problem, it's messed up, the neckline's gaping. For me to be able to fix that and have that challenge, that's one of the things that I really enjoy about sewing. So it's like, oh, challenge accepted. Like, let's do it, let's figure it out. But I made the ribbed cuffs on this sweater really long. I really like that look. And overall, like, I'm just in love with this sweater and the pattern. We just gotta fix this and we're gonna do it. So those are all my hoodies. All we have left now are sweatpants. And then I have one dress that was a fail, a huge fail. I don't like dresses, period. Let's talk about Glenn. If you don't know who Glenn is, watch my favorite pattern video. So these are my Glenns, and I'm obsessed with them. These sweatpants are so cool, and they're great. So one of my favorite things is that they have this cool angled seam right here, and also the thick cuff. I'm not gonna go into too much detail about these because I do cover them pretty thoroughly in my favorite pattern video. So if you wanna know more about my Glenns, then go watch that video. But since that video, I have made them in white French terry. Daring, I know. But I'm just, sorry, this is getting, got a little folded in there. So yeah, I made a pair of white pants, LOL, right? I just love the fantasy of fashion, the fantasy that I can wear white pants, but I'm very careful when I wear them. Knock on wood. So yeah, those are my Glenns, two pairs of those. Now, my Mels, my other sweatpants that will go with the dream suit. So we've got this, y'all know these pants, I already showed them off. First pair I sewed of this pattern. Second pair that goes with the other hoodie. And then this is my third pair that I have not made a matching hoodie to go with yet. I do like how neutral this fabric is, but I will say I did get a little bit lazy on these and they're not quite as neat as the other ones. And I had made another pair of the kind of this color, I don't even know what to call this, pastelish. I had made another pair and a friend of mine actually ended up buying them, so I had to make myself a new pair. So that would be what, 3, 4, 5, 6 pairs of sweatpants for just me, and then I sewed a pair of friends. So 7 pairs of sweatpants, I don't know when, but that's a lot. I love sweatpants, what can I say? I know what you're thinking. Why the hell is she wearing pants with a dress? I'm not in support of the look either, but the reason I'm doing it is because this dress is so short. So this is gonna go in the fail category. It is a cute dress, but it is just too short, and I suck at invisible zippers. I don't know if you can tell, there's a bubble going on right here. Nobody wants that bubble. But it's lined it with a bed sheet. And if I just had made the skirt a bit longer, it would be a lot more flattering. It's a bit constricting on my chest as well. I just don't feel like this one fits very well. So we're gonna confidently put this in the fail category because my butt hangs out of it. End of story. That is all I have for you guys today in terms of what I have been making lately. I very much hope that you enjoyed my first attempt at a sewing vlog. And I do hope that you'll return to my channel, especially for the video I was discussing earlier regarding mistakes that I have made in my sewing recently and how I have overcome those obstacles. I think that that will be a very interesting video if you are somebody like me. Now, these time lapses that are going on are just some previews of some of the footage that I've accumulated and am planning on putting out here in the near future. Lastly, just a shout out to all my homies who like to sew. If you're into my content, like, subscribe, leave me a comment, talk to me, do all that stuff, and watch my other videos. Thank you guys so much. See you in the next one.